SBS acknowledges the traditional custodians of country and their connections and continuous care for the skies, lands and waterways across Australia.
You're listening to Australia Explained, an SBS audio podcast helping you navigate life in Australia.
Yiridamarang, hello. I'm Luana Grant, executive producer of NITV Radio. I'll be your host for this special episode of The Australia Explained. Today, we'll explore how Indigenous art serves as a window into the rich cultural landscape and history of First Nations.
My grandfather paints with ochre and does that through dot work. He taught me how to paint with dots. So I use a combination of his techniques of painting with dots and my grandmother's symbolism.
Embracing their oral traditions, Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples have used art as a medium to pass down their cultural stories, spiritual beliefs and essential knowledge of the land. Art also serves as a window through which one can gain a deeper appreciation for their unique culture and creative traditions. So let's find out how Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples have embraced their oral traditions using different forms of art. Indigenous art is a rich tapestry encompassing a wide range of styles and techniques, each deeply rooted to First Nations peoples' individual country, culture and community. Maria Watson-Trudgett is a Koori and freshwater woman of the Wiradjuri people. She is a First Nations consultant and a self-taught artist who is passionate about sharing her Aboriginal culture. Ms. Watson-Trudgett says people often have misconceptions about what Aboriginal art is.
Some people have a preconceived idea that dot painting is traditional and the only true form of Aboriginal art. But this is not the case, and it's flawed thinking. Our traditional art was really not necessarily art, but more about making marks for identification on your tools, etc., or engravings in trees for marking ceremony and burial locations, or body paint, etc., the ceremony.
In fact, dot painting only emerged in the 1970s with the Western Desert Art Movement from Papunya. This small Aboriginal community is located northwest of Alice Springs. It was there that Aboriginal artists began painting their traditional stories using acrylic paints on boards.
There's many styles of Aboriginal art that artists use to convey their stories and their cultures. Aboriginal art is anything an Aboriginal person paints that connects them to their country and their culture and creates for them a sense of connection and belonging.
Ms. Watson-Trudgett began painting in 2009 to relax from the stress of full-time university studies. But she soon realised that art was much more than just a way to quieten the mind.
Art to me is very important because as an Aboriginal person, it's about me sharing my stories with other people, keeping my culture alive. It also supports me connect to my Aboriginal culture and to my country and to my old people and to the knowledge that I learned while I lived and grew up on country with them.
Ms. Watson-Trudgett's art is a contemporary fusion of abstract art and cultural motifs, which uses flowing lines and Aboriginal symbols, echoing the way her ancestors communicated when drawing impressions and symbols into the ground. She explains.
The symbols are really up to the interpretation of the artist that's using them. So if you see symbols, I guess you would never assume that they mean the same thing to another artist.
For Gamilaroi, Bigabul and Yorta Yorta artist Akira Rose Armstrong, art has always been a part of her life. Ms. Armstrong's art is greatly influenced by her grandparents who were both artists. Her grandmother was a Gamilaroi elder who was one of the last sand painters in the region.
She would tell her stories while sitting on the ground, on country, on sand country, and she would tell us stories in the sand. So she would depict her journey and her story through artwork. So a lot of the symbolism and imagery that she would tell us was shared that way. So I then take that imagery and put it onto canvas to share that way.
Her grandfather, a Yorta Yorta elder, taught her the techniques.
My grandfather paints with ochre and does that through dot work. He taught me how to paint with dots. So I use a combination of his techniques of painting with dots and my grandmother's symbolism in terms of circles and lines and, yeah, looking at country from that bird's eye perspective, I suppose, to share story that way.
Ms. Armstrong describes her art as intertwining of her two countries. She says that working on an artwork allows her to reflect what country means to her, evoking many emotions.
So many emotions. You know, you have that sense of pride and joy, and when we don't live on country, it's a connection point to reflect on what that country means to us. I think from that emotional perspective is it's a process. Is that, you know, as you're completing each artwork, emotions come up as you're retelling that story, thinking about the relationships that are connected to that story.
And she shares these with her daughter.
To continue culture, you need to share culture and you need to practice culture. To share with our next generation is to make sure that they're always at the table having those conversations. You know, regularly she sits down and paints while I paint or draws while I paint. Sits down and listens to the stories whenever I complete each artwork.
Davinda Hart is an artist with family roots in the southwest region of Noongar country, Western Australia. He spent his childhood in Adelaide before reconnecting with his culture on Nimba country, New South Wales, later in life. Mr. Hart experienced significant challenges during his early years. He left school at 16, struggling to find employment and battling substance abuse. However, the support and guidance from his uncles and brothers were instrumental in helping him turn his life around.
I had a bit of an unhealthy way of dealing with a lot of issues that come through life, and it was really great that I was able to be fortunate enough to meet my uncles and brothers now, who teach me these stories about country. It teaches you how to conduct yourself and all those type of things in a positive light. And so I just put those into my everyday life, and it does make things a lot easier for myself.
The knowledge Mr. Hart has acquired is often reflected in his artwork.
So most of the stories talk about Mother Earth, the ancestors that walked before us, and also our creator Baimi, who lives in the stars. These teachings that I have learned come so far west of New South Wales, and so I did spend and have been spending a lot of time out there with the community out there and been learning a lot of knowledge from that area, and that is coming through in a lot of artwork that I do today.
He says that art is not only a way to pass stories to the next generation, but also a form of healing for him.
Definitely a relaxed state as I am painting. I do a fair amount of reflecting as I am painting. I'm thinking about the design and how it's going to, you know, come together, only a little bit, but I think for most of the time, you know, like the spirit just really takes over that painting, and the painting kind of just does it by itself. But, you know, it's very therapeutic, and yeah, it's really great.
For non-Indigenous people, First Nations art can give a deeper appreciation for their unique culture and creative traditions. Ms. Armstrong says a great starting point is asking about the stories told in the artwork.
Who is that First Nations person? What are those countries and what do they look like? Once you start asking those questions, you start to see and feel that person. These stories have been passed down generationally, and they will continue to be, just because that's the way that we share our culture. How can we make space to hear those stories?
She enjoys being at her own exhibitions and having an extended yarn with people about the artwork. Mr. Hart adds that asking questions about the artwork can also create connections.
Just be really open. Don't be afraid to ask questions. When non-Indigenous people come to me and ask about my work, a lot of the time they'll say, I don't mean to offend you, and you're not offending me. You know, I'm really glad that you're asking me these questions, because then I can, you know, give you the best possible answer from my knowledge and learning together as well. If it is something that I don't know, then we can both figure that out together. And within that conversation there, we're building a connection just through that.
Thank you for listening to this episode of Australia Explained, written and produced by Yumi Obar. Australia Explained Managing Editor is Rosa Germian. And I'm Luana Grant. Until next time.
This was an SBS audio podcast. For more Australia Explained stories, visit sbs.com.au/Australia Explained.